Hit the subscribe button or visit us at auau.auanet.org.
Robotic bladder auto transplantation in a brain-dead, heart-beating deceased donor. A wet run before first-in-human clinical trials for bladder transplantation. Bladder transplantation has not yet been successfully performed. Technical challenges include complicated deep pelvic vascular anatomy, limited visualization, and procedural complexity. In preparation for a first-in-human clinical trial of bladder transplantation, we performed a robotic bladder auto-transplantation in a brain-dead, heart-beating research donor. After an appropriate research donor was identified, bladder auto-transplantation was performed, including extracorporeal backtabling. The primary objective was to develop the stepwise procedure for the surgery and to gauge its technical success, defined by autograft perfusion, by direct visual inspection, and indocyanine green fluorescence. Secondary objectives included intraoperative parameters, such as operative time, warm ischemia time, and estimated blood loss. We first developed the posterior plane. The right ureter was identified and ligated. Next, the right externoiliac artery and vein were mobilized and ligated. All vascular structures lateral to the internoiliac artery and vein were mobilized and ligated. Posterior and lateral planes were connected. The right internoiliac artery was ligated at its distal limit. The lateral attachments were freed, and the bladder was then mobilized. The bladder neck was transected with care to leave the trigone intact. The left ureter was then mobilized and ligated. Posterior division of the hypogastric vessels were ligated. The distal venous limit was ligated, and the left-sided vascular pedicles were freed. The right common iliac artery and vein were clamped using bulldogs, which began our warm ischemia time. The vascular pedicles were freed at the level of the right common iliac artery and vein. The specimen was bagged and removed for backtabling. On the backtable, the allograft was perfused with UW preservative solution, and enticide vascular anastomoses were performed for the artery and vein. Silk sutures were placed for orientation. The venous anastomosis was performed first. F- followed by the arterial anastomosis. Now we were ready for reperfusion. After reperfusion, we evaluated our allograft using ICG fluorescence, which had diffuse uptake throughout the allograft and at the arterial and venous anastomoses. Lastly, we performed our vesico-urethral anastomosis. This table demonstrates our operative results. In the brain-dead heart-beating donor, the technical maneuvers were well tolerated with intraoperative hemodynamic stability. Operative time was 670 minutes, and visual inspection revealed a pink healthy bladder and patent vascular anastomoses with diffuse ICG uptake. This is the first documented case of robotic bladder autotransplantation performed in a brain-dead heart-beating research donor as a necessary preclinical step towards a first-in-human trial of bladder transplantation. Technical feasibility was demonstrated, and vascular viability was confirmed by ICG uptake. The robotic approach was necessary for the fine vascular dissection in the deep pelvis.